If you want to learn how to make 3D text effect like this using Adobe Illustrator, then I recommend this channel to you. Hello everyone, this is Blaben and welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time in here, where have you been? You know it is free to subscribe, right? So please go on and hit on the red button and turn on the bell icon to all so you don't miss out anytime I release new videos. Please do well to give this video a thumbs up by hitting on the like button as well, and let me know what you think by leaving them in the comment box down there. Having nothing more to say, why don't you come along with me into the world of Illustrator and let's start making beautiful 3D text effect. Welcome to Illustrator. Quickly, we're going to work on the background. Okay, I'm going to be applying a radar gradient background over here. So I'll be using the color listed here for the 3D text effect design. Let's select the canvas and let's choose the gradient fill. But before I do that, I'm going to be selecting my rectangle tool this way, and I'll be drawing a shape this way to cover the entire canvas. With my gradient property selected, I'll be choosing the radar option, and I'm going to be selecting the black here, and I'll select my eyedropper. Make sure I pick from this side. So quickly, let me select my eyedropper, and I'm going to select from this side and select the other, and then I'm going to select from the other side as well. So that is it for the background. Now the next thing is to type in my text. So with my type tool selected, I'll be typing anything that we want to type. So let me go with brown. Then I'll be changing the font style to Oblex Pro. I'll make sure to leave the link to download this text if you want to, but you can still use any other bold font for the design. So I would want to increase the size a bit. So with my shift key and alt key held, I'm going to hold this portion and just drag out. And now the next thing I would want to do is to quickly come over here to the tools under the tools panel. I'm going to turn off the fill over here. So let's click this none. Let's click on it, and you realize that there's nothing over here for us. So quickly, let's come to our appearance panel. If you can't find your appearance panel over here, don't worry. Just head on to the Windows tab over here, click on it, and browse on to look for the appearance. The shortcut key is Shift F6, so that will quickly launch your appearance panel for you. So I have mine here, so I'm just going to click on the appearance panel, and over here we have some buttons that we need to work with. So I'm going to be clicking on the add new fill, click on it, and we've successfully added our new fill. What I'll be doing onto this fill is to add a gradient to it. So from now on, I'll be calling this fill. So adding our gradient, first of all, let's choose our gradient guy over here. Let me push this gradient in here this way, and I'll be selecting a linear gradient, not with what I just did, but let me use the white and black. And I'll be picking my color from the list of colors that I just created. So let's select this, and our color picker, select this first of all, and let's select this, and let's select the second one. So these are actually the hexacode for the colors that I've listed below. I'll make sure I leave those ones as well in the description, so you could easily create yours as well. And the angle, let's turn the angle to -90 degrees, and this is okay for us. So quickly, let's select our move tool, and that is for the first thing to do. Let me bring back my gradient guy over here. The second thing we need to do is to still come back to the appearance, and with our first fill, what I'll be doing is I'm going to be duplicating this fill two times. So quickly, let's hit with our first fill selected, just hit on the plus this way, and we have our second fill selected. So select your second fill and change the color to white. This time we don't need the gradient there, so I'm just going to change the color to white, and quickly move on to, with our second fill still selected, just click on the plus icon to duplicate it. So with our third fill selected, we're going to change the fill color over here to this ash, right? Good. So to do that, I'll be selecting my eyedropper tool, then I'll just make a selection this way, and that is it. So let's go on and select our move. So now that we have this done for us, quickly I'll move on to the first fill, select the first fill, and what we'll be doing is to add an effect to it. So come to the add effect, the FX icon or the button that you see where they click on it, and let's move on to path, and let's choose offset path. With this, I'm going to be selecting a negative number for the offset path. So negative, I think 2 should do. Let's click on OK and let's see what happens. Okay, so you could rightly see that this, you know, line over there makes it look amazing. So that is what we wanted. So great. So quickly with our third fill selected once more, let's come to the add new effect and let's choose distort and transform. Then let's move on to transform. Let's select transform, and over here we are going to work with the move, not the scale. So forget about the scale and let's work on the move. So in here I'm going to turn this to a negative number. Mind you, this is in, it should be in pixels, so make sure everything is in pixels. So I'm going to turn this to negative 0.2, then let's turn the vertical also to 0.2 pixels, and angle should be left at 0 as it is, and let me add the pixels to it. So when we come to copy, let's change the copy to 30 copies. Okay, and let's preview this to see if so. Yeah, that is all we have over here, looking good for us. So 30 is okay. Well, better still, we can, let me make this 0.3, or maybe let's say 0.4 isn't bad, it's okay. So quickly let's hit on okay for us. So now the next thing is to duplicate the third fill to get a fourth fill. So with our third fill selected, let's hit on the plus icon as well, and let's change the color to something we can easily, you know, work around with. So let me choose red. I think the color red, or better still, the color green would assist. So in here I'm going to push this guy up to the first fill. I just want to have a view of how it is and do some small touches. Okay, so in here, so what I'm going to do is to click on the drop down and let's delete the transform that we already have in here. Let's delete it, and let's add a new transform to it now by hitting on the add new effect, and let's move on to distort and transform, and let's use transform. So still on the move item over here, we are going to change this part to, let's say, 6 pixels, and that of the down part to also 7 pixels. So this is okay as we have it in here. And what I'm going to be doing is to quickly, I'm not going to add any copy, so I'm just going to say okay, hit okay over here, and quickly I'm going to drag it back to where it was, right? It was on the fourth part, and there you have it. So quickly what I'm going to do next is to add another effect to this, but with the effect I'm going to be adding the path, then offset path. Okay, so in here we're going to make this 10 pixels, but we're going to change it to round, and if this is okay, we can, you know, quickly move along with okay, so let's make this 15. Let's change this to 15 pixels, and 1 2 1 2. Okay, let's click on okay, and I want to make some changes over here. I think I did some with the transform. Yeah, with the transform over here, let's quickly, this should be in negatives. Okay, so negative 7, not 7 itself. So quickly we should have something looking like this for us, and so let me see if 6 will do. Okay, so let me make it 7 as well. Or better still, let's change this to 8, negative 8, 8. So this should, okay, I think this is looking okay. So let's hit on okay. So now the next step is to select this fourth fill, which is this color, and we are going to apply a gradient to that. Okay, so let me quickly bring this guys over here, and with my gradient selected, I'm going to be adding a linear gradient, and this part should, you know, select, pick your eyedropper, and this part should go with this, and this part should also go with the yellow color. Now with this, the angle, I'm going to also turn the angle to minus 90 degrees, so this is looking good for me as it is. So let's go on and select our appearance again. And so with our fourth layer selected, what we are going to be doing here is to duplicate it again. So by hitting on the plus button over here, and with our fifth layer selected, what we're going to be doing is to add an effect, that is the distort and transform effect. So let's go to transform over here. So it says apply new effect. Let's hit on apply new effect. And over here, we're going to, so the first, always the top should be a negative number. So negative 0.4, the vertical should also be 0.4. Then when we come to the copy over here, I'm going to make this 50 pieces, 50 copies. So that is the effect we have over there for us. So let me try and see if I could reduce this to something about 3. Let's, I think the 3 isn't bad, or better still, let's make it 2 and see. Okay, so that is not bad as well. So let's go ahead and hit on okay, and we are going to change this color to that of the final color that we have over here. So with our eyedropper 2 selected, let's quickly hit on this to change the color. I'm not getting the effect that I want, so let's go back to the transform and let's transform this. So the second transform, not the third transform, the second transform. And we can, you know, increase this to about, let's say 0.4, and let me make this to 0.4. so this should be in the negatives. Okay, that should be in the negatives. Good. Then let's go ahead and hit on okay. So what is happening here is that we are having a gradient fill. We don't need a gradient, we need a solid fill. So quickly, I'm just going to do away with the gradient. I don't need a gradient. Okay, so that is that. So let me select my move tool, and quickly, I'm going to be dragging this guy over here. So the final touches I would want to apply to these guys is to add some, you know, inner glow and some drop shadow effect to the text. So with my appearance panel over here, I'll select the third fill, which is the ash color that we have over here, and I'll be applying a drop shadow effect to it. So come to the add new effect, and let's choose stylize, then we can choose drop shadow effect. So with the shadow effect, I think I'm not going to do much over here. I'm just going to leave it as it is, and let's go on and hit okay. And quickly, I'm going to select the last fill, and I'm going to add another drop shadow effect to that as well. So come to stylize and drop shadow effect, and with this one, well, I'm going to maybe increase the blur a bit, and probably increase the Y part to 6, and maybe increase the increase the X part to -6 as well. So that is it. I'm going to leave the mode to multiply and the opacity to 75 as it is over here. So let's go on and hit okay, and we are not actually done, so we are left with some few touches to make this look awesome. So with my fourth fill selected, I would want to add some, you know, inner glow effect. So let's choose the add new fill, and with the still the stylized, I'm going to choose inner glow. So with the inner glow, I'm just going to increase the opacity to 76 or maybe 77, then probably decrease the blur to about 4. Then I think that will be for that, and hit okay, and that is it. Our 3D text effect is ready for us. So now that we've gotten this done, we can duplicate it and use this to write anything that we want to write out of it. So I'm just going to, you know, wipe this up and type Adam. So with any text you want to type with this effect, you can equally have it. Alright guys, so this brings us to the end of today's video tutorial. I believe you've learned something new. If you did, please go ahead and smash the like button and do well to subscribe if you have not yet done that. Make sure to leave your thoughts in the comment box below and I'll be glad you did. Having nothing more to say, until I come your way next time, never stop creating. I'm out.